I know a lot of us look at this pandemic, this quarantine, and even the year of 2020 as a bad thing, but I was born with some type of disposition that allows me to see the positive in everything. I mean, really, I have this crazy ability to take the good things out of bad situations and apply them to my life. 2020 has been brutal, but it's eye-opening experiences like this that allow us to reset our focus on what is actually important in life. I've been quarantined this year, which means I've had a lot of time that I spent alone just thinking. And during that 14 days, which felt like an eternity, I actually picked up some really good frugal living habits that I wanted to share with you. What's up, man? My name is Reggie Bryant, and this channel is all about personal finance and personal growth so you can better yourself every single day and live life on your own terms. On this channel, I talk about saving money, increasing your income, getting out of debt, and I talk about several personal growth topics, and I bring them all the way back to my own personal life experiences to serve as a motivation to you. Let's get into the video. In my 14 days of solitude, I sat and I thought very deeply about, like, everything. And I know it might sound like torture to you, bro, but I actually enjoy my own company. I'm the type of guy who can go out to eat by myself or go out to the movies by myself. There's no shame in my game. Then my friends ask me, who are you going with? And I'm like, myself, bro. They're like, yourself. Don't you feel weird or awkward being out in public by yourself? Nah, bro. Solo dolo, baby. You don't gotta take somebody with you every time you go out. The reason I'm telling you this is because my living room is literally a mini movie theater. I have a flat screen TV, I have a receiver, I have speakers, and I have a very big bassy subwoofer that makes a lot of sound. So when you're sitting down watching a movie in my living room, it actually mimics the feel that a movie theater has. So since I was quarantined anyways, it's not like I was going to go anywhere. Plus, it's not like any movie theater around was even open because at the beginning of this whole pandemic, literally everything shut down. But in that moment, I realized that I have so many streaming services that I don't even have to pay for. It's not even funny. There's so many movies and TV shows that I can be watching and catching up on in the comfort of my own living room with an experience that rivals that of a movie theater. And all that movie equipment that I just showed you that I have in my living room, all that only cost me $200 out of pocket. That's all I paid for it. And that was years ago. So let me ask you this. How much money do you usually spend when you go to the movie theater? 20? 40 bucks? Oh, you want to add snacks and drinks to that? Cool. For a nominal fee of an exponentially inflated price tag of what should be a $3 cup of popcorn costs you $10 and it doesn't even taste that good. Yeah, I said it. Bro, I got snacks and beverages at the house. Y'all better stop playing with that mess. $6 for a large cup of Coke. Are y'all kidding me? Get me a 2-liter for $2, bro. Y'all better stop. Oh, and don't let it be a date. That'll run you $50 to $60. Oh, you want to see it in IMAX. Oh, that's going to run you $70, $80. Even though I'm exaggerating just a little bit, the numbers I'm throwing out there are actually pretty accurate. With that said, watching movies at home is a frugal habit that I picked up, and it's something that I haven't really done on a consistent basis prior to now because I was so caught up in the experience of going to the movie theater, feeling the atmosphere, the food, the smells, the gigantic room that you're in watching the movie. I just like that kind of stuff. But, you know, you get over that real quick when you're in the middle of quarantine and you literally can't experience that. So you got to make the best out of what you have is what I'm getting at. Now that the movie theaters are open again, I'm still in that habit of watching movies at home, and that saves me quite a bit of money because watching movies is one of my favorite pastimes. And I used to go to the movie theater, whether it's with friends or by myself, I would go all the time. Seriously, it was one of my vices. Also, if you're wanting to have a date night, way cheaper if you watch movies at home. That's all I'm saying. Which brings me to my next frugal habit. And this is more than just something that's about frugal living. This is something that every man needs to master. Really, any adult needs to master this. You know the feeling when you're spending a Saturday night alone and there's nothing on TV, you've had a long week at work, and all you really want to do is sit back, relax, and chill, but there's nothing to do. So now you're bored out of your mind, and all you wish for is just that somebody was there with you. You ever feel like that, bro? I'll be completely honest and transparent with you. I really don't get that feeling like that, bro. I really don't. Like, I enjoy other people's company, but rarely do I ever crave other people's company. And it's not because I'm some cold-hearted, mean person who has no friends and hates people. even though some of that might actually be true, it's because I know exactly what I want out of life and I know just what it takes to get there. And I say that because I understand that when you hang out with too many people on a consistent basis, that can throw off my energy and it can shift my mindset in such a way that conflicts with my goals. And I know that for a fact because I've actually been there. You see, there is something about you that causes certain people to gravitate towards you, no matter where you're at, where you're from, what your name is. Some type of person gravitates towards you. And since I know that there's going to be people who gravitate towards me, just like people are going to gravitate towards you, I've come to this realization. If I am not protective of my time, that puts me at risk of giving too much of my time and energy to the wrong people. And that's not conducive to the success in my life. And it's definitely not conducive to the success in your life. Does that make sense? I know this may sound pretty uncommon, but I'm way too preoccupied with making things happen, building my future, and fulfilling my purpose in life to be concerned about hanging out all the time. And that's why I have no friends. You may not realize it, bro, but people influence you, especially the people you see the most. You'll hang out with a group of friends or even family members, and there'll be some general conversation. And that general conversation turns into opinions, views, what you want to do in the future, how work was this week, what you do for fun. Only for the conversation to be redirected by someone else's opinions of what you should be doing, of what your goals should be, of what your views and opinions should be. Tell me I'm wrong. Anyway, as much as I enjoy other people's company, I personally have to take people in very small doses. I can literally count on one hand the amount of people that I can spend a prolonged amount of time with on a regular basis. Facts, you know? I can be a very outgoing person, but I'm introverted and sometimes people drain me. But my point behind that is this. Hanging out with people on an overly consistent basis can deplete your bank account. Going out to eat, going out golfing, going out bowling, going out for drinks. These things can add up very, very, very quickly. And don't get me wrong, these are fine every once in a while, but I usually see that guys typically do this all the time, like every week. You think that doesn't drain their bank account? Bro, don't you know that when I say you're the average of the five people that you spend most of your time with, I'm talking about the amount of money that you spend, the amount of money that you make, the amount of debt you're in. I'm talking about your relationships and your overall quality of life. Don't you know that? If you don't believe me, pause this video right now. Think of the five people that you spend most of your time with and tell me you're nothing like them. I'll wait. Now that that's out of the way, if you as a man or just as an adult in general have issues being alone, if you can't come home after a long day, relax, shower, cook something, put some music on, turn the TV on, read a book, do something productive. You can't do any of that stuff without feeling lonely. You become too dependent on others to make you happy. And something I've always refused to do is leave my happiness in someone else's control. So if that sounds anything like you, bro, please reassess yourself. On that note, I did some reassessing when I was on quarantine myself, except my reassessment was on my belongings. I wasn't just looking at what I currently have. I was looking at what should be my belongings that will save me money in the long run that I don't currently have. I started with the kitchen. I opened the refrigerator. What'd I see? A bunch of bottles of water. And I thought to myself, I need a Brita filter and a pitcher to go with it. Like, pretty much all I ever drink is water anyways. Like, why am I wasting my money on these bottles of water and I could just get a Brita filter? Doesn't make any sense. Another thing, I was on quarantine and barbershops all around were closed. I was like, you know what? I'm looking rough right now. I need to figure out how to cut my own hair. And I also need to get equipment to cut my own hair. That would save me hundreds of dollars every single year. Way less expensive than going to the barbershop every other week. So as I noticed these things, I started taking a mental inventory of what might seem to be a bit expensive up front, but will save me money in the long run. And once I narrowed those things down, I just went ahead and ordered them. But then I realized I was making a huge mistake. And this isn't going to sound frugal at all to you, but I promise you it is. My mistake was not investing into my YouTube channel. My YouTube studio, which is just my office, was super bland, and the camera that I was recording my videos on was just my iPhone. And that's fine when you're just getting started, but I was making videos for like a year and a half, and I was wondering why my channel wouldn't grow. Now, I know, you're thinking, Reggie, what does this have to do with frugal living? I'm getting there. Something you will always hear me say is invest in yourself. And there I was, not taking my own advice. So I had two problems. I wasn't investing in my YouTube studio, which meant people weren't staying on my videos for very long at all, which meant that it was going to take that much longer for my channel to get monetized. That was problem number one. Problem number two was I had the means to buy the camera, the lighting, the studio setup, the equipment, everything, but I just chose not to. And the crazy thing is, I didn't even have to go out of pocket for all of this stuff. That's the crazy part. But here's the frugal habit I picked up to redeem myself. So my job gives out these awards whenever you do a really good job and you get recognized by somebody. These awards can either be given by your boss or your peers. And here I was, not using anything that I got sent. I had just all these awards, literally tons of them just stacking up in my account. And then when I went to check, I was like, oh man, I have all kinds of awards in there. And these awards have monetary value that equate to gift cards and certain items that you can get on the shop. To make a long story short, you see these lights behind me? Yeah, well, the awards that I got at work paid for majority of that cost. Like, I only had to pay like $25 out of the like $200 that these cost. So basically the camera, the lens, and the lighting, that's really all I paid out of pocket for, and I wasn't upset about that one. And my point is this, bro. The moment I got the new camera, the lighting, and the new studio set up, all of a sudden my channel started actually growing. How's about that? So that obviously leads to more money in the future. And in my opinion, when you put money into something that's going to get you more money in the future or save you more money in the future, in my opinion, that is one of the most frugal things you can possibly do. And I say that because when you do that, you are truly thinking about the future and not just about the now. You know the funny thing about being quarantined and having all the time in the world to cook? I don't think I cooked one time throughout the entire time I was quarantined. I kept myself so busy thinking about the meaning of life that I didn't even consider that I was ordering food way too often. Like if I had to give an example of what a normal day looked like during my quarantine, I might have had like a Pop-Tart for breakfast, might have ordered a pizza for lunch, and then I might have ordered a power bowl of chicken and rice for dinner. And if it was cheat day, I ordered a nice dessert to go on the side, you know what I'm saying? And sure enough, they were up here faithfully too, dropping the food off right at the doorstep, that no contact delivery. So obviously I formed a bad habit because that just got me deeper and deeper into not feeling like cooking, and it was just so much easier to hit a button and make a few phone calls and get food delivered to my door, you know what I mean? I know this might sound like common sense to you, but this is something that I recently had to improve, like actively improve within my own life, so I'm gonna share it with you anyway. And I realized two things. I ordered pizza a couple of times, and I ordered desserts a couple of times. But don't get me wrong, I didn't just order pizzas and desserts every single day. I only ordered them on cheat days where I could eat whatever I wanted to. Well, anyways, this was a very easy problem with a very simple solution. You know, I realized, hey, I'm ordering these pizzas, I'm ordering these desserts. Just go to the grocery store after quarantine, pick up those frozen pizzas for $4 if you must eat pizza on cheat days. And if you want to get desserts, pick up some cookie dough or some brownie mix or something and just bake some brownies or bake some cookies and you're good. That's your cheat day right there. You get a lot more for a lot less when you do that. But before I ever made it to the grocery store, because again, quarantine, I didn't leave the house. I just stayed right here. I realized I was going to challenge myself to see how long I could go with eating for free. And when I say I ate for free, I'm not talking about the groceries that I already bought ahead of time that I was just eating. That's not eating for free. I mean, that's money that I spent on food. I actually ate for free for a prolonged amount of time. You see, right before quarantine started, I helped some friends of mine, my friend and his wife, I helped them move out of their apartment, and they went to move across the country. And as they were moving, it was a really long process, but we moved the furniture, we moved all their belongings very, very, very quickly, within just a few hours. And because I decided to help them, they gave me a bunch of food in return. I'm talking about all kinds of like canned foods, snacks, ramen noodles, you know what I'm saying, cornbread, olive oil. I mean, these were a bunch of common household items that I didn't have. I mean, they had soups, you know, they had all kinds of stuff. Tuna, green beans. They had so much food that I was literally just kind of overwhelmed. But the thing was, I put them right in the pantry and I honestly forgot that I had it. And that was why I was doing all that ordering food and stuff. But anyways, bro, it was easily $100+ worth of free food that I just had at my disposal that I forgot even existed. How sad is that? Well, anyways, a lot of the stuff I don't typically eat, but they had some kettle corn in there, so you already know I destroyed that because kettle corn is delicious. Amen. But there was also a bunch of ramen noodles in there, and I think ramen noodles are kind of bland, so I got creative. I started, you know, I got into the habit of cooking, kind of, I guess. I boiled some water, and once the ramen noodles cooked, I cracked an egg in there, and then I cracked two eggs in there. It is delicious. You need to try it, bro. I'm trying to tell you. That stuff right there will get you right. Not to get too off topic, but basically I got super creative with the little bit of food that I had that was free, and I challenged myself, how long can I go just eating for free without even having to hit up the grocery store? That's what I did. And you know what? Milk and eggs went fast, okay? I have more than that. I don't have to just survive off of milk and eggs. They had some ragu sauce in there, so you think I'm not putting that in my spaghetti? You already know. I already got noodles. They had rice in there. They had all kinds of stuff in there. I'm trying to tell you, like, that gave me a good 2 weeks. I mean, this is even after quarantine. That gave me a good 2 weeks of just eating for free. I'll tell you what, that alone saved me hundreds of dollars, but the habit wasn't just to go out and help friends move so that they can give you food in return. The whole habit and the whole idea behind what I did is getting creative about what you have and thinking of ways that you can save money with what you do. I just simply used my resources. Oh man, I've had this in the cabinet for like a week and I forgot I had it. Let's see how long I can go eating for free. And that habit got me back into the habit of cooking. That habit got me into spacing out the amount of time I go and visit the grocery store. If one thing quarantine has taught me is that you don't need all the stuff you think you need. You think you need daggone 20 things of toilet paper. You really only need one. You know what I'm saying? You're not no crazy person. Just, what do you do? Use a whole roll every time, bro? Nah, we don't do that over here. You think you need eggs, you think you need milk. Why? I personally don't even eat cereal like that, so why do I need all of that milk? Milk runs out, so you're gonna run to the grocery store and get some more milk? Not me. I'm out of milk. Hey, next time I go to the grocery store, I'll pick up some milk, but I'm not in a rush to go get it. That's not the first thing I reach for when I hit up the grocery store. You might not even agree with what I'm saying here, but the point, I want you to get the mindset. Not so much what I did, just get the mindset behind it. The mindset is, you might think you need milk and eggs and cereal, but what you really need is food. But you know, the biggest habit I got out of this was the habit of refraining from going out to eat. I made it a whole month and a half, and that's progress for me. I made it a whole month and a half without going out to eat. If quarantine has taught me one thing, it taught me that you can absolutely break the natural pattern of which you do things and still be just fine. Not going to the movie theater, okay. Not going out to eat all the time, okay. Not going to the grocery store all the time. Not going to the barbershop. I mean, seriously, it's given me a whole new rhythm of how I do things. And this new rhythm that I have right now is saving me money. I'm not saying that your habits are going to be the exact same as mine, but it's the thought process that what builds this into such a powerful, powerful thing. If you've been quarantined, I'd love to hear in the comments frugal habits that you've picked up. Or if I said something that you disagree with, no matter what your thoughts are, just leave a comment. I want to hear them. I want to see them. I want to respond to them. Anyways, that's the video for today. Thank you so much for watching. My name is Reggie Bryant, and this channel is all about personal finance and personal growth so you can control you, control your finances, and control your life. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Stay cold.